Yes, it is Sega, isn't it, Mr. Hun?
Yes, Sega! Knuckles the Echidna in Sonic the Hedgehog 2.
I am incredibly ashamed that I have to use a ROM for this, because my capture devices are not working and it's not on Steam.
Yeah, we were talking about that. Steam apparently has Sonic games. I was not aware.
Yeah, of course it does.
Yeah, this could be cool. This is interesting because, this is my favorite Sonic game, Sonic 2, but this is the weirdo version that you get when you put the Sonic Knuckles cartridge.
Yep.
You put the Sonic 2 cartridge in the Sonic.
I will not be defeated by a spring. Well, I'm just doing this for something different. Darn it. Playing as regular Sonic is a little too easy.
Okay, I thought you said that this game was easier with Knuckles.
It is, up until the final boss.
Yes.
Well, the special stages are easier.
Yep. I didn't introduce myself properly, so hi, I'm Hunter the Hunter Mackinan. I make videos on YouTube, like, occasionally. This is kind of your official coming out of hiatus dealio, isn't it?
Maybe. I might upload this after a game review that I've planned, but...
Oh, sweet. I'm looking forward to that.
I can't tell if that was sarcasm, so I'll just assume it is.
Ah, it's great. It's great to finally, like... And it's, like, weird. Because I have this game technically on the... on the Sonic Mega Collection. Well, not technically, I have it on the Sonic Mega Collection, but I played, like 5 minutes of this.
I have Mega Collection, I also have it physically.
Alright.
So, I'm incredibly ashamed. Anyway, here's a special stage.
Okay, can you just give a mission statement to the audience, like what we're doing actually today?
Well, we are simply... Yeah, read the title of the video. It's a let's play of Knuckles in Sonic 2.
So we aren't gonna beat the game?
Well, if we don't, then I can shame myself as a Sega kid.
Yeah, it's interesting. Like, I
have beaten every of the original Sonic games with all emeralds in time.
Yeah.
Even Sonic 3 and Knuckles that has 14.
I could never get any of the Chaos Emeralds in any of the games except Sonic 1.
That's ridiculous. Someone who can speedrun Mario 3.
You call an hour 20 minutes a speedrun? Come on.
Kinda, yeah.
No, that's not even remotely a speedrun. Like, I'm pretty sure there's way faster ways.
Hey, look, a Chaos Emerald.
Yay, we have the first one. First of 7. I wonder if they boosted it up to 7 just because it's kind of, 7 is kind of a mythical number.
I don't really know, honestly.
It could be. Well,
there's a difference when playing Knuckles. Your ring counter does not reset to 0 after a special stage.
You just had 69 rings for a second there. Just wanted to point that out.
99 red bananas.
Ah,
look.
99 zip Luftballons.
And after this, stay tuned for Hanu's speedrun of Fire Emblem on hard mode.
One of the reasons I can't forget the Chaos game is because I'm not really a big fan of the game. Just don't.
Talk up, man. We can barely hear you.
I said that one of the reasons I can never get the Chaos Emeralds in this game because I'm not really a big fan of this game.
But isn't it worth it just to unlock the Super Form?
I've never unlocked the Super Form and, no. For me, playing Sonic 2, like, it's like I just sit down with the game and I just play it all the way to the end. That's what I get out of Sonic 2.
But in Sonic 1, having all the emeralds, you get the ending that brings life back to the Green Hill Zone.
Anyway, the only thing difference is that at the end, at the very, very end, I think, is that Robotnik's, like, jumping angrily on the end text.
In Sonic 1, Sonic will use the emeralds in the Green Hill Zone and causes a whole bunch of flowers and stuff to appear.
Oh, yeah, he does that. That's kind of anticlimactic, honestly.
No, it's not. The whole point, he's saving woodland creatures and he just brought life back to the Green Hill Zone.
Yeah, it's the same flowers that you see at the end of every level. I really like... getting to the point, I really love Sonic 2. This, the Emerald Hill Zone is, well, it's Green Hill Zone 2.0. It's not as memorable as Green Hill Zone, honestly. I've never been as big of a fan of it.
Pro tip, don't use that spring. You'll land right on an enemy.
Aw, man. Those angry, not angry, those mean Sega people. Oh, yeah, the interesting thing about the background story of this game, actually, I might as well talk about it, because when else am I going to get a chance to do that? You know that this was developed by the American Sonic team? Well, it was Yuji Naka, but he moved to the United States to make this game.
Hmm.
Have you heard that story?
I think so.
Yeah, he was, if you know anything about Sega internal politics during the 90s, they were not cool. And
whoops.
Even Yuji Naka was so fed up with it that he basically decided that he was going to distance himself with the Pacific Ocean between himself and the main office.
Also, I apologize if I'm playing rather poorly. It is much harder since I can't use a controller.
You're playing way better than I ever played this game.
By my standards, this is actually quite a poor performance.
but still, compared to me, somebody who didn't... I never owned a Mega Drive.
Well, I offered to get you one, but you keep shooting me down.
Yeah, right. But the thing is, I legit love unpopular opinion. I actually like the Mega Drive more than the Super Nintendo.
What?! You're a Nintendo kid!
I am a Nintendo kid, but, Mega Drive just had way more... I'm not saying, it's, objectively the better system or anything.
Yeah, I like it more, but I admit it may just be nostalgia.
Yeah, but the games are just way more interesting and, off-kilter and weird, and that's what I like about the Mega Drive.
How am I doing, Hana?
Yeah.
That's three emeralds.
You got, such weird titles on the Mega Drive, like friggin' V-Cap Attack and things like that, which you don't. And people always, they bring up, their favorite Super Nintendo games. It's always stuff Final Fantasy VI, Secret of Mana. It's always, a bunch of RPGs, and I don't honestly care.
RPG is my favorite genre, if you must know. Although I like Shining Force way more than Final Fantasy.
There's one exception to that rule. On the Super Nintendo is Earthbound. I actually played all the way through that game when it came out on Wii U.
Earthbound or Mother, whatever. I actually saw that game at a game store here, physically with a giant box. Cost about $300.
Oh, good on you. It's quite rare. It never got released in Europe because.
Hey, I didn't say I bought it. Come on.
Yeah, but even seeing a physical copy of it is quite rare because. It didn't do it because it wasn't a popular game or anything. It only attained that popularity after the fact, much later.
Yeah.
Like I said, in Europe it never even got released, but that was just because it was an RPG. And they would have had to have translated it at least into Spanish, French, and German for it to be.
I know. I hope you've been taking notes in this Let's Play. And I'm not going up there. Watch out for that dot!
Going back to this game, did you know that also that Sega Technical Institute actually helped Yuji Naka make this game partially?
Hmm.
Yeah, they picked up some of the slack when this game was,
Die! Rookie trap.
Aw, man.
How shameful of me.
Just all your rings. Aw, man.
I was gonna use those rings to buy Hanu a new chili dog.
That's so weird. I've never understood why chili dogs were chosen, as Sonic's, favorite food.
Hey, nobody questions why the Ninja Turtles like pizza.
True that. Good point. Turtles must have started that, when everybody, every cartoon character seemed to have signature food that they like all of a sudden.
Oh man. I was doing so well, too. Oh well. And yes, I did intentionally miss those checkpoints. Because I planned to nab them. You just gotta nab them in order, because once you get one, it auto-gets everyone that came before it.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Oh, yes. What is this you're doing now?
I'm agreeing with you, so, but you know about the Sega Technical Institute?
A little, yes.
Yes, and they also helped out on Sonic 3 as well. Specifically, I think this is like public knowledge now, but... You know that Michael Jackson was supposed to make the music.
Oh, he did. He just wanted to be uncredited.
Well, no, he never actually completed it. And there's like two different like possibilities, like why he didn't. But then when he didn't like go through with the thing, that's when Sega Technical Institute pitched in, and specifically on the music front.
Oh, I'm. Have you ever heard of Pop Fiction on game trailers?
I think I have. I think I've watched it, yeah.
Yeah, you know, where they cover video game myths. I died on purpose, if anyone's wondering. Don't worry, that will not happen again.
They got some, like, I remember the episode, and they got, like, some very vague letter about the reasons behind, like, why Jackson dropped out of the project.
Since then, I think it's been revived. Well, they had a video quote from someone who worked on it. One source says he was uncredited because of the, you know, the whole pedophile thing, but, one source that they, for reasons they're not allowed to say, but they trust more, is that Michael Jackson was unhappy with how it sounded on the Genesis and didn't want to be credited.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was getting into, that those are the probable reasons that the controversy about the child molestation thing, was one reason that Sega kind of wanted to distance.
We're not gonna discuss that case. Way too controversial.
No, of course not. But I'm just saying, like, and that's so weird too. Like, just to think about the fact that Michael Jackson used to be like really tied with Sega for a while.
Although he hated how the Genesis sounded. Genesis, Mega Drive.
I can't understand really because the sound chip on the Mega Drive. Not nearly as good as Super Nintendo. Although, like, some people actually prefer that sound. Like, some people don't like the Super Nintendo sound because it's much lighter. It's got kind of like a bubbly quality to it. But then there are Mega Drive games that have a fantastic soundtrack. Like, the Sonic games are, like, you know, the first example.
This white one used to murder me as a child.
Okay.
Hey, don't you shrug me off with an okay. How many of your stories have I listened to?
It's easy for you now, right?
Well, relatively speaking. Although I'm not as good as I used to be. No!
Okay.
Well,
I gotta pack the bike.
So much for that. Oh well. Oh well, it's okay. Luckily...
Okay, sorry, but I distracted you with that. Okay, what was I even talking about?
You were about to give me 20 nickels.
It's a Mega Drive sound. The Mega Drive sound chip is not as good.
Look, in the system's defense, the Super Nintendo came out 2 years later. The Genesis Mega Drive was...
Exactly, but...
It was built to compete with the NES.
Exactly, and also, another thing is that there are Mega Drive games with fantastic like the Sonic game for one thing, Streets of Rage 2 is another one. I really like the soundtrack in Heat Cap Attack, and also I actually really like the soundtrack in Mickey Mouse House of Illusions and Zero Awakening. Zero Awakening is awesome.
You ever played a Master System?
I have.
Fun fact, if you jump like the split second before you get hit, you'll actually hear the sound but not lose any rings.
Sweet.
Do not try to do that on purpose. Seriously, it's a bad idea.
Yeah. So I have played a Master System, but not when it was new, like back in 2012 when I was in Glasgow, actually, like in this pub.
Pretty impressive machine, actually. Like, if you turn it on with no game in there, it has this little startup screen and... Even a little maze game you can play while it shows instructions on how to put a game in.
Yeah, that like the Model 1?
I think so, yes.
Yeah, because the Model 2 had Alex Kidd, like, as a built-in game. And if you put it on,
what?
If you turn it on without a cartridge.
Oh, we are denied the pink emerald again. I'm sorry, viewers. This is disgraceful for me.
Hurry. Hurry, at least. At some point. But we are in Zone 2.
Will you stop being such a Hano?
Oh, no, I got so wrapped up in everything, I forgot that we actually completed one level.
And these first few I'm intentionally taking a little longer, just so I can nab the emeralds.
Okay, that makes sense.
It makes sense to me. Hanu actually disapproves of 100%ing games.
I don't disapprove of it, I just don't do it. Because I'm lazy.
Tomato, tomato. Lazy. You went on a huge tangent about how stupid the concept is.
When did I do that?
When you were playing the 3D Mario game on Wii U.
I don't remember going on a tangent about that. In fact,
about how it wouldn't let you progress unless you collected more of this stuff.
Are you getting this mixed up with Sonic Lost World?
No.
Because Sonic Lost World's the only review I remember where I ranted about the fact that it was a collect-a-thon.
Oh, I didn't say it was in a review. It was personal.
Okay.
You take a loop-de-loop and pull.
The 3D world wasn't too bad. Like, it... Yeah, you had to collect a certain amount of stars every time.
Okay, so it's 3D world. You get the titles mixed up sometimes. Really stupid naming. Sorry. I'm sorry, Mr. Nintendo Man.
Especially because I don't know how the 3D part in that. For the 3DS, it made sense, but for the Wii U, this is perhaps something else to have a 3D.
Huh. I used to be so good at this, but now I'm not. Whoa!
Question, Patrick. Like, yes, I did play a Master System in that pub in Glasgow, and they had a Mega Drive also, and they had a cartridge of Zero Wing, and I was, like, so... I'm so happy that I can actually say that I have played Zero Wing on an actual Mega Drive.
The only Mega Drive game I own is Bonanza Brothers.
Nope, only one you own.
Yeah. Not Mega, Master System
and
game.
Master System.
Yeah.
That was a Master System game, too. What
yeah.
Was it?
Yes, it was released on both systems. Why wouldn't it be?
Okay, so... Is it exactly the same game, basically?
Yeah. Although, probably don't look quite as nice.
But yeah, I really want to play Bonanza Brothers more, but I only have it for that little at games.
Your little handheld Mega Drive.
Yeah, the handheld you can hook up to a television. It'd be cool, but the audio is, the audio is just outrageous, and not because it's Mega Drive, but because the handheld system, for some reason, is compressed. So it sounds awful.
You know, I never actually go up here. Wonder why.
Well, because if you keep running forward, you go the other path. I've gone the other path.
Oh yeah, there's two paths right here, depending on whether or not you go from a top or below.
Yeah, that's a really cool feature. That's one of the things that's really cool about Sonic 2.
We're going back.
Alternate paths.
Well, Sonic 1 had more alternate paths. You just had to believe.
Did you just say Sonic 2 or Sonic 1?
1 had more alternate paths.
Well, yeah. Maybe in the later levels. Yeah, it does. The Spring Yard Zone had them, and, Oh, yeah, because we did... We did the Let's Play of the first game with Retro Kaiser. Sorry to block that, but I was just saying because we got stuck in those last few levels for a little while and Kaiser kept dying over and over again.
I bet you didn't even know about the little trick in the first level. Oh, the little whirly platform. Get to the top of a hill, jump, and spin dash down the hill. Propel you backwards. You'll eventually break through a wall and get a nice little star and shield.
The new thing I found out about the first Sonic that I didn't know about is that you can actually roll through some of those walls.
You didn't know that?
No! Why would I know that? How would you...
You can't do spin dash, for one thing. Well, the thing is, when you're running...
You can't run up, but you can roll into a ball. I consider that the proto spin dash.
Would you stop? Let me explain, Mr. Not Informed. In the first Sonic game, you move faster. Well, if you're running and hit down to spin, you can move faster than if you just keep regular running. So discovering stuff like that was fairly common.
Yeah, but I didn't know. I always took the long way around those parts. So it was cool to find that out, finally. That was interesting. I haven't even commented. We're on chemical plants.
I knew that when I was 6. Or younger. Even Sonic Generations that brought it back?
Of course I do. I did a review of it. That's something I wanted to talk about, actually, was the Sonic review videos I made, a couple of them where I reviewed all the, like, the major Sonic installments that I've played. And the second half of that video, I've looked at it a couple of times, and I'm kind of proud of it. It's a really good one. The first one looks terrible. You remember that?
I'm not answering that.
Games.
Was that before you had capture card and your webcam was yellow?
No. I had video footage and everything. I did all the classic Mega Drive ones, Sonic 3D. You commented on that video because I reviewed the Mega Drive version and not the Saturn version. As if, like, the Saturn version somehow, like, comment, you could just get it anywhere.
I got a copy of it from Kaiser.
Yeah. Well, I've never even played. That's one system that I still have not played at all physically.
Makes sense. Saturn's got some good games. It just wasn't advertised too well. Like in the Nights in the Dreams commercial, they throw a PlayStation out a window to demonstrate that it can't fly like Saturn's Nights. Fly, weakling, fly. You're not ready.
Yeah, Sega was definitely ahead of its time on the weird commercials and stuff.
It's a thing that the leading company doesn't do that, because they don't need to. That's why you'll see ads of Pepsi bashing Coke, but not the other way around.
But it was weird, like, you know, Sega just, like, brutally went after Nintendo when the Mega Drive first arrived.
They had to. Someone had to break that monopoly.
Yeah, but it's weird, like, that any other company that's... Oh, man, we didn't get it again, did we?
That was 10 rings short. Thank you. If I didn't hit that stupid mine... I'm gonna go beat up a mime in their honor.
But it looks god-awful because I had the wrong video setting on it, and I captured so much footage, and I didn't feel like doing it all over again. I just over with it.
Oh, man, I'm really hating how this ROM's making the Wawa look. This part on it.
Is it making the water look weird or something?
Just the top of it. But hey, this part on it. So many deaths.
This part's way easier now with Knuckles.
You'd think so, but no, because you can still get crushed by those things.
Oh, yeah, but the wall climb is, like, really useful. This is so weird.
No! Time to do this.
Because, you know, like I said, Sonic 2 is my favorite game, and now you're playing it basically with one of my favorite Sonic characters. That's kind of interesting.
Knuckles doesn't jump as high as Sonic. That's something that really slows you down at many parts. But he can glide and climb.
Yeah.
Cause you know, you can call me Knuckles. Unlike Sonic, I don't chuckle. Whatever the heck that means. You did that on purpose. Man, I am not paying attention. This is actually really poor for me, because I'm usually quite good at these games. Although, if you see me actually with a controller. My favorite is actually Sonic 3 and Knuckles.
Oh, yeah, that. Which one do you prefer, Sonic 3 or Sonic 2? Because those are the games that people always talk about.
Whoa! Huh, I didn't even know you could go right here.
Wow. Oh, God. Wow. Just...
Are you making fun of me? Stop making fun of me. Like you knew that.
Have I told you that the only time I've ever gotten stuck in this game because of, like, a bug was specifically in Chemical Zone? I don't remember which act, though, or two, but I got stuck to a wall, inside a wall once.
So what do you think, Hanu? Should we go on to Sonic 3 if this goes well?
We could. We could.
We could. Is that...
If Red Rockhazer would be happy with that.
Oh, yeah, I think he was doing Sonic 3, wasn't he?
Yeah, well, it seems like, well, that's kind of coming like a running gag now. Like, we're doing on his channel. We're all, they're all Sonic games or Sonic-like games.
Well, maybe I'll just include Retrokaiser in that one. In there. Because you know, you can screen share to more than one person nowadays.
Oh yeah, I've done it.
You've done it! You've done it! You've done it!
In the Heroes of Might and Magic 2 with Darabka and Retrokaiser. And that would be cool, that would be cool. I could be like the big friggin'... That's why I feel so bad that you weren't on the friggin', the most recent White Devil podcast. You missed it.
Well, how am I supposed to stay up till 3 in the morning and wake up early?
Well, I don't know. But that's the thing, because we talk so much about, like, Sonic cartoons. It's like, between, like, you, me, and Kaiser, we're, like, the biggest... We would have been, like, the biggest Sonic...
That stupid pillar. Sonic could jump up and break it. Knuckles would have to start on that log.
Ah, yeah. That shitty log.
Hey! It doesn't look that, man. As a kid, I used to love messing with these leaves. Yep. Darn it.
Yeah.
I did not mean to get...
For me, it's the other way around. I really like Sonic 2. I've never been that big of a fan of Sonic 3. And it's not that I hate it.
Yeah, it's because that's... Yeah, it's that you hate it. See? There it is.
Are you kidding? No, it's a good game and everything, but I think it's simply because I never played it when I was... Well, I played when I was younger, but I played it, like, when the N64 was already out, so, like, in the late 90s.
You gotta play it with Knuckles. That way you get the complete game. Even a couple of the audio tracks are different.
Oh yeah, I played through like Sonic 3, the regular version. So maybe I should do that.
Which is only half the game. But it was still enough for me to like it so much that I...
The soundtrack's fantastic, I love it.
You were fantastic. Absolutely fantastic.
I like
the big ring thing.
I played Sonic 1 and 2 a lot on my cousin's Mega Drive when they still had it. And I played it a lot, and
one time I triggered a real funny glitch on the stage with Knuckles.
Oh yeah? What did you do?
Oh, you wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Well, God fucking damn it, you can't just preface it. Like, I had the funniest thing happen, and you will not believe me.
Well, you saw that platform that was spinning around up there at the beginning?
Yep.
There was, like, one that had three of them spinning in a circle. I was gliding, I glided onto it, and it actually broke off and just, like, rocket propelled me to the bottom of the screen below the level, and I died.
Oh, man. Yeah, weird.
I wish I could do that again on purpose.
I guess that's... That is... Kind of, I must have had something similar that time when I got stuck inside the wall in Chemical Blast Zone. I mean, if you do weird shit enough in a game, like, you will break it.
Well, doy. Video games 101, this part. Also, there we go. See that?
Yeah, that's what you had to do.
Knuckles' lack of jumping.
Oh,
stop I know I'm running out of air. Don't worry. These bubbles always come at just the right time. Except when they don't, of course.
That's a load of bull.
No, it's not. It's a load of cheese. But you know, on this stage, you don't have to go underwater at all. Well, not there, at least.
Okay. Yeah, but I always screw up the beginning, and then I have to go underwater anyway.
Oh man, that reminds me in Sonic 3, those piranhas. Those things.
Yeah, those were annoying.
They latch onto you and just.
They get your rings. That sounds weird. It sounds like a big boomerang, but.
Oh, I thought you were gonna make a wang joke.
What do you think I am? Retro-kaiser?
Yes, actually. I'm still not fully convinced you aren't secretly the same person.
I can't even do an Australian accent. I tried it on Let's Play.
Well, the thing is, you're trying to do an accent when you should be trying to do a person with the accent. Okay, I know that sounds weird, but it actually does help.
I don't know why I can't do an Australian accent, though, because I used to watch so, like, this is, like, how weird Finnish television is. Like, I've watched my, like, more than my fair share of, like, Australian television shows.
Don't worry, anyone who claims they can do an Australian accent is lying, unless they actually have one.
I can only do the freaking crocodile.
Well, don't focus on the Australian part, try to do a retro Kaiser impression. I'm going down! Ow! Look at that!
I just imagine, does Kaiser have, like, a weirdly high-pitched voice?
Well, don't you have just a weirdly non-Finnish voice?
This is only for professional reasons.
Yes.
I'm an English teacher, but...
Yes, because you don't have an accent. You don't have that accent at all.
I've shed my accent.
Can you do a Finnish accent?
I can do, like, a super exaggerated one. You get a feeling, like, if you've ever watched the Mint play, you know, Ocarina of Time or whatever, like, you get a feeling for what a Finnish accent sort of.
I started watching that last night on a Chromecast, and then I fell asleep.
That is so stress-inducing, that whole... That's the thing I remember also from playing Sonic.
Crying out loud. Scrotus. Screw you guys, I'm going home.
Wow, that's a really good card. Again, we did the 10 voices challenge on the podcast. You totally should have been there. Oh, so I have to ask your opinion then on this. Have you watched any of the Sonic Boom television show?
A few of it, yes. And I must say it is most grudness. I sure do approve of that here show. It's not my yet, I tell you what.
Yeah, I liked it too. Both me and Kaiser really liked it. So.
Too bad about that game, though. Main showpiece garbage.
Yeah, that's weird. That's weird, like.
Yeah, it's not even the exaggerated bit, like a lot of them 3D Sonic games that were actually not bad. This one is genuine. Oh, yeah, I went there. Shoot.
What do you think about Stick the Badger?
Oh, that's her name.
Now I'm getting a sneaky suspicion like you haven't actually watched the show.
I have, although many episodes they don't refer to her by name. Although I actually do like the character. It's nice to have another female on there. That's not just an Amy.
Okay. You don't like Amy?
Well, I don't like Damsel in Distress Amy. But in Sonic Boom cartoon, she's actually like one of the fighters, which is nice. And is not just stalking Sonic.
Yeah, well, there's plenty of that too, but like Sonic, like Amy is one of those characters you love to hate. Or I love to hate. Well, it's a teeter. Like sometimes she is annoying, but like I just like her. I just like her as a character, basically. And Styx is wonderful, like. First of all, I just love the fact that she has a hot voice.
Styx is wonderful. Oh, insert the... Oh, let's all take that clip out of context.
Yeah,
Sorry,
that's
Spax.
That's a really hilarious cartoon. I don't remember what it's from. It was probably some new draft collection, but like...
Sorry, Spax, you didn't deserve that. If you don't know, Spax 3.
A new Sonic character? I must draw porn of it.
Oh, that's from Sonic Shorts.
Oh, it is. Okay, makes sense.
Which they finally did another one of after many years, and it's like 20 minutes long.
Sweet.
Sweet!
A fair bit of them, but I haven't seen all of them.
So, can you go toe-to-toe in voice acting with Seth MacFarlane? Huh. Didn't see that coming.
Probably not.
By probably not, was that your attempt at a Brian voice? You don't watch Family Guy?
Of course not.
Is it because you're too afraid of Peter Griffin?
Is that the dad?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Even though off-screen he's been kind of funny about it, like confirming Stewie's sexuality in a magazine that nobody would read.
Stewie's the baby.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't watch Family Guy, so I have no idea. I mean, I know Seth MacFarlane. I think it's impressive that he can do so many voices. I mean, I made this clear a lot of, in other contexts as well, that I just admire people.
Stewie the baby. So, here's a funny story that you'll probably say, what, to?
Yep.
In an article of a magazine that I'll tell you what it is later, he confirms Stewie is gay. That magazine was Playboy.
Oh, okay. What? You expect me to have a huge reaction to Playboy?
No, the fact that he would confirm that fact in an article of Playboy.
Oh, man. I read this from a legit news site.
Darn you, Grounder!
But it's weird, like, you know, Playboy magazine's actually... planning to stop doing, like, straight-up porn?
I didn't know that because I don't read the crud.
Because the competition's too high now. Like, they've realized, like, you know, that you could just get it free on the internet, so...
Hooray! Finally, they're going down after all they've done.
Just like, okay.
One of these three spin things. That's where it happened.
Yeah, where the fuck
Here, let me say it again. It was one of those three spin things. Darn you, Grounder!
That always reminds me of Yoshi. You know, that's not, like, exclusively a Yoshi's Island thing, but those kind of spinny platform things, they always remind me of that.
Gliding through the level, because I'm done with this level.
This actually looks cool now. Oh, but...
No!
You can't just climb those totem poles.
No. And I can't even just jump to the top of them like Sonic probably could. Like, this bottom one is not enough for me to reach him.
Oh man, your jump is so short.
Yeah, okay, this is another... Yeah, okay, Robotnik is really kind of lacking in his boss robots. This one is a hammer that hits two totem poles.
Oh yeah. That's one of my oldest vlogs, like the top 10 dumbest Robotnik fights.
Was it all Sonic 2?
Sonic 1 as well, and then there was one from Sonic 3, which was the ice level boss fight, because that's just friggin' stupid.
He said stupid!
Yeah.
And of course, the number one choice was that first one with the first fight in Sonic Adventure, because you can just spam the homing attack and beat him in 10 seconds.
Oh, yeah, but that list was exclusively like Mega Drive games, but, are you one of those people that interchangeably says Robotnik and Eggman?
I say Eggman on the 3D games and Robotnik on the old ones.
Okay. Makes sense.
No, it doesn't.
I'm kind of different about which one to use.
That bottom one's not high enough for Knuckles.
Yeah, I noticed that, and you can't reach the high one, man.
There we go. You know, his face always... You know, as a kid... As a kid, I always wondered why he was smiling as he, like, went off, but now I realize he's supposed to be angry.
Yeah, it's not the same thing as smiling.
Wiggle, 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 wiggle.